Hello, my people. How are they? Thank you very much. I want to thank all of Fana for the very massive support one they give to this our Ogbonge series, what we call Medicine in Pidgin English. And I also want to thank you too, where vote to decide this particular interesting, nice topic where we will discuss today. And that our particular topic we will discuss today, now that they call hereditary. Okay, hereditary, might be the topic we will discuss today. Now, I want to explain in a very simplistic and very sweet way. Okay, very easy way. What can be this hereditary? Now, this hereditary, make you just see and say, now those important or those characteristics, those traits, those things where person fit collect from their mama, their papa, or from their generation. So now it be those things what they call hereditary. So anything where be say person fit collect from a mama or from a papa or from their generation, now it be hereditary. Why it be say, I talk say also from your generation? The thing be say, he get some particular gene where be say, for your mama and your papa, if he no show for their own body, but he dey for their generation. For example, I don't get question for my email where somebody asks me, say, for in family, you know, then get, they no get, in papa and in mama no get colored hair for head, but him can't get colored hair. But he don't know, he don't hear, say, one of their grandfather for their, one of their mama, be papa side, been get colored hair. Say, whether this thing, na normal something for him to get them, or na something where he go they fear, it may be na some other things where they cause that particular thing. And I tell him, say, it's possible, say, na actually na genetic something where you don't collect. Because for some generation, some particular gene, feel they silent, feel they recessive. But for another generation, if they very active, if they dominant. So those things, if they happen. And this particular topic, it will help us answer a lot of questions concerning this whole, you know, issues where they go around for our place now, where they talk about, this one no be my picking, this one are my picking, oh, my face no day like this, my hair no day like this, my eye no day like this, why my picking eye go day like this, and all those, you know, conversations and argument and stress where they happen for our society today. So some of these basic concepts, we give understanding to everybody, make you for understand how these things, they actually they happen. And when you don't understand how they happen, you can know which particular step to take in which particular situation. So I'll encourage you, make you follow the video as we go there, discuss some. Okay, so now before I go deep inside, I will talk about some very few terminologies, some very few words where we say we're gonna see, we're gonna hear as the discussion they go on. So one of that word today now, what is that they call alleles? Some people they call them alleles, some people they call them allele. Some people call them allele, anyone where you want call them, understand? Provided say you know what you they talk about. Uh-huh. So alleles, what be this particular alleles we don't talk about today? What we go talk about today? Alleles now actually alternate form of gene. Okay? Now this alternate form of gene, now that gene where would they actually collect from our mama, and when they collect one copy from mama, one copy from papa, this gene, they actually separate during what they call gamete formation. When papa and mama come together and they want to reproduce, you get gametes where they form. During that period, one of that gene go separate from another one for mama side, one go separate from another one for papa side, and they go confuse together randomly again during fertilization. Now that gene that they can call alleles. So now alternate form of gene. Now we get one copy from papa, one copy from mama. Okay. Now, what will be the next important point where I would like make we follow up for today's lecture? The next one now, dominant alleles. Dominant allele, dominant allele. So what will be this dominant allele? Dominant allele, now that particular gene where they fully expressed. The particular gene where we say when you see the person, now that gene, now that particular one, they expressed in the person. Don't mean a person where you get strength, okay? Where they show. For example, when we talk about this dominant and recessive gene, if he talks, say, me on a no vex, but make I use this example. If he talks, say, iPhone, for example, na dominant gene. I know say some people go vex. Person will use iPhone. People, they usually they identify. Oh, when that person use iPhone, he they dominant. He they easily seen. Now, na dominant gene. Then, when you use Android, when you use Android, for example, you know, or Android, now, if we put them in the category of waiting, recessive gene. So I want just make you understand, like in a very simplistic way, understand, when people carry iPhone, it is very easily seen. People, oh, man, now an iPhone Pro Max 12. But you never, you know, they hear say, oh, man, I carry Huawei 21 or Huawei 33. You understand? People need to really identify like that. But person carry iPhone 12, come on, wow, an iPhone 12 be that. So it's a dominant gene. Understand? It's very dominant. So those genes, those particular genes, where we say, they actually, they show, they suppress other genes, then show forth. Now that one that they call dominant. For example, we get gene of, for example, blue eye and brown eye. But some people, they can't get brown eye. For example, that brown eye where they see, na dominant gene. You know, mean say, if you check the genetic combination of that person, the person fit get even blue eye inside in genetic combination. Maybe in a heterogeneous gene where you get, and the dominant one na brown eye, and then the recessive one for that heterogeneous pair, the recessive one na blue eye. Therefore, the dominant one will come show na brown eye. Say you get them now. So dominant gene are the one where they show well, where they very dominant. Okay, now the next point now, recessive gene or recessive allele. I don't already explain some things about that recessive one. Recessive one now, for example, like I talk, now our brother Android. Android or recessive gene in general. Now that gene will be say, it is they suppressed, it need a show, it need a show at all for inside, you know, the phenotype of the person. We'll explain what it means phenotype later. So it need a show on the physical part of the person. So it need a easily they see him. Now that one they call recessive. It means a dominant don't cover him. Understand? And that one they call recessive. So for example, we are like 200 people there now. If people flash out their iPhone, people will get Android go put on for pocket. And that one be dominant, don't cover recessive. So recessive go there for pocket. Yeah, now that one they call recessive. I know they talk, say, if you they use Android, no be a bear go. I'm not, I know they push anybody to go do anything, no, but I'm just using an example. Okay, so iPhone now dominant in that case, then Android now recessive. So recessive gene, now that gene when they easily they show forth. Now that one they call recessive gene. Okay, now if we go further, we will see what they call homozygous dominant. Homozygous dominant, for example, now when, for example, you see here like this, I'll go right here, let's say gene for brown eyes, I write here B, now capital letter now for dominant, then I can put another B. So homozygous, homo means say then they're the same, then they're similar. Okay, so now maybe they see BB. Now BB now the same, and then they what? Dominant. You see dominant. So means say you see I'm for capital letter. So capital letter means say then they dominant. So you see I'm saying now homozygous dominant. Now the opposite of this homozygous dominant, now homozygous recessive. So you go see something like this. Small b, small b. So you see this is now homozygous recessive. And this one now homozygous dominant. You see, the same but a big letter, the same small letter. Small letter now recessive, big letter now dominant. Now, then the last form where you go see here now homozygous, heterozygous. Heterozygous. Heterozygous means say, hetero means say, you know, it contains different, not the same. Hetero, it contains two different things, not be the same thing. So you go see, say, it will contain one big B and one small b. So this one now will be heterozygous. One big B and one small b. So this one have some basic concepts. I want you to repeat them again. Allele na alternative form of gene, okay? Where they actually separate during gamete formation and then come back again, randomly fuse during fertilization. Dominant allele na the one where they show, the one where they say the presence they show. For example, black hair, you know, if you get gene of both black and red or brown hair, then black hair na dominant gene, then the other color na recessive gene. So na black hair they show, so that one be dominant gene, okay? Then recessive, like I talked, recessive na the one when they easily, when they express phenotypically, when they suppressed by the dominant gene, okay? Na be recessive allele or recessive gene. Homozygous allele or homozygous dominant, where they see, and when the two gene, where they dominant, now they show for the person. So there is no recessive. So now they say BB for homozygous dominant. Small b, homozygous recessive, and then heterozygous, now big B, and then, you know, small b. All right, so for the next slide, we go discuss the other terminologies. So see you in the next slide.